Hey guys, John from the John Muir Show here, and in recent years we've heard some folks say some things that are scientifically impossible are now somehow possible, and of course, spoiler alert, those things are not in fact possible. We hear these people saying that, oh yeah, you could just wake up one morning and even if you're a woman, yep, you can just claim that I feel like I'm going to be a man today and you can be a man for that day. If you don't even want to be a man for the full day, you can change back to being a woman at any point during the day and everybody else is supposed to go along with it. Oh, and by the way, it's not just limited to men and women. Male and female are no longer the only two genders. There's like dozens upon dozens of other genders. Like if you want to be like a microwave or a toaster today, that's okay with them too. Yeah, this is the sort of stuff that we've had a bunch of progressives trying to shove down our throats. And needless to say, yeah, we haven't been going along with it because we just didn't really feel like taking the brains out of our head and tossing them in the nearest trash can. So we've said things like, you people are crazy. How about you look at science? You pretend to care so much about science when it comes to climate change, but all of a sudden when science isn't convenient for you anymore because science is telling you that there's two genders and you can't just one day to the next go from being one to the other and then decide later that day, oh no, I want to go back to the other one, and oh, it's been 5 minutes now, I'm back to being the other gender again. Yet you can't exactly do that. Science says, yeah, not really possible. So anyways, the reason I'm talking about this is because, yeah, it was probably inevitable, but allowing this whole, like, oh, you can totally change your gender to any of the 63 other genders at a moment's notice thing, it was bound to cause other problems than just the progressives who say it sounding like complete morons. And yeah, we're starting to see some of the fallout from that. See, over in the Netherlands, there is a guy who is 69 years old. He is about to turn 70. He's not thrilled about it. So he is actually filing a legal petition to say that, nope, I want my age changed from being 69 to 49 because I want to turn 50 again instead of turning 70. Yeah, this is like actually happening. The courts over there have to rule on this within the next month. And he was citing, you can read the whole quote in the blog. He'd said, because people can do some of these things, and there was like a couple of rational things, okay. But then he said, oh, because people can decide whatever gender they want to be on this given day, that means that I can decide what age I want to be. No, like I said, you cannot decide from one day to the next that, oh yeah, I'm just going to switch to this totally made up gender because I feel like that today and anybody's intolerant if they don't go along with my mindlessness. Like, no, that is not the case. And also, yeah, sorry, just like biology kind of determines if you're a man or a woman based on what's in your pants there. Yeah, at the same time, biology does determine your age as well. Look, you might not like the time and place that the good Lord chose that you were going to be born, but guess what? The good Lord chose you were going to be born at that time in that place, and there's really not a whole heck of a lot you can do to change that. So for the love of goodness, can we please, I'm appealing to all of you progressives out there that are trying to be like, oh, it's intolerant to tell people they can't literally do everything that they want in the world. Can you please cut the crap? Like, over in Europe, you're causing some real problems right now, and it's only a matter of time until that comes to the United States as well. It's all the time that I have for today, but tune into the John Muir Show each and every weekday, 8:40 a.m. on WTAQ, 9 a.m. on WSAU and WHBL. Till next time, I'm out.